state of Cincinnati and our council in expressing support for House Bill 392, which is also named the Intimate Partner Violence Bill. In the United States, Ohio and Georgia share the unfortunate distinction of being the only two states that have not modernized their domestic violence laws. Frankly, it's a distinction that I'm not proud of and one that none of us should be proud of. On October 28th, in 2015, our council unanimously passed a resolution in support of this bill because we know how important closing the legal gap is for Ohioans who are victims of abuse but are not considered a spouse or family member of the abuser. In fact, we joined up with our colleagues in Dayton, Columbus, Cleveland, and Toledo. We're all in agreement and we all passed similar resolutions in support of this bill. House Bill 392 modernizes Ohio's domestic violence law by expanding the definition of the victim to include persons in committed and romantic relationships, not just those who are married or family members. This protection is because there is an inherent danger of every victim when they leave their attacker. In fact, more than 70% of women are killed by their abuser when they are attempting to leave the relationship or after they've left the relationship. Ohio's current law only protects families or household members and does not protect individuals in serious or romantic relationships but who are not married to the perpetrator. The IPV bill will extend necessary protections to all persons who are in serious or romantic relationships with their abusers. We know in this day and age, many individuals are in long-term relationships, either older or younger, who are not married. All abuse and domestic violence victims should have the same legal protection so that they can prevent further abuse and violence. Expanding liability for abuse and domestic violence related offenses to victim partners falling outside of the current definition is a crucial step in protecting these individuals. I'm going to give you an example of someone who might not fit the profile of a victim that you might assume. We have people of all ages and backgrounds in cities and in rural areas. Oxford, which is the home of my alma mater, Miami University, had the first murder in many years, the death of Rebecca Altemeyer, who was a student, a 21-year-old student at Miami, who attempted to get protection, could not. She fled her attacker, who was her 27-year-old boyfriend. He followed her to campus, shot her in the head, and then killed himself in her apartment. If she had protection, she might be here today. In America, one woman is fatally shot by a spouse, an ex-spouse, or a dating partner every 14 hours. Every 14 hours. Since January the 1st of this year, there have been 584 domestic violence gun-related fatalities similar to Rebecca's. Domestic violence victims are at their most vulnerable, as I said before, when they're leaving the relationship, 70%. Every day we don't extend this protection, lives are at risk. All Ohio citizens in serious and romantic relationships deserve the same protection from domestic violence as everyone else currently protected. I urge you to take action soon by passing House Bill 392 out of committee, and in doing so, sending a message to all victims of domestic violence that they will have the same protection from their abusers as all others. Thank you for your time and allowing me to speak.